Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making green bean fries. And this is something I'm doing for Super Bowl day because I feel like you should have a hearty meal of some kind. And I have done a casserole. I don't know if it's available yet in Betty's Kitchen. And I've also got some hamburgers coming up. So if you want something like a vegetable, but it's fancied up a bit, then you might like green bean fries. They're like French fries, only instead of potatoes, they're made of green beans. And I know that a lot of people don't like vegetables, but you might like them this way. We're going to start with a large bowl, and into that bowl we're putting 1/4 cup of lukewarm water. Now lukewarm is about 105 degrees. And into that lukewarm water, we're adding 1 teaspoon of active dry yeast. So it's just from a packet like that, measuring out 1 teaspoon. Then we're going to stir that together and then let it stand for about 5 minutes. While my yeast and water are resting, I'm coming over here to the stove where I have water that I have brought to a boil. It's about a couple of inches of water in a large pot. I'm going to salt that. I have 1 teaspoon of salt that's going in there. And then I'm adding my green beans. I want to parboil them. I want them partially cooked before we fry them. We're going to be deep frying like French fries. So I'm just going to get a packet of these and bring it up and put it in the pot and continue until I have them all in. Now this water will stop boiling, but I will bring it back to a boil. And then these will just need 2 or 3 minutes. And then I will be bringing them out and putting them in a cold water bath to stop the cooking. We want to keep them nice and green. If they continue to cook, they will turn a drab olive color. Let's mix up our batter while our green beans are cooking. Here we have our mixture of water and active dry yeast that has been sitting for about 5 minutes. We're adding 3/4 cup water. Also 1 well-beaten egg. One cup of all-purpose flour. And 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And I'm going to stir this around. And after I get all of the flour incorporated, then I'll whisk it for about 30 seconds. I've boiled the green beans for about 2 minutes, so I'm going to drain them through a colander. And then plunge them into ice water. Here we have our green beans, here we have our batter that we mixed up, and here we have oil. It's peanut oil, and it's been heated. There's about 1 inch of it in that pot, and I have my thermometer on. It's past 350, but as soon as I put this cold, these cold vegetables in, it will come down in heat a lot. So I'm going to quickly work here and get about 12 of these and dip them into this batter. And then into the hot oil. This is like 6. And you want to just do batches at a time and then bring them off onto paper toweling. These look about as brown as I want them to be, so I'm going to grab some of these with the tongs and bring them out and put them here. When you get each batch out, take some coarse salt, some kosher salt, and just sprinkle lightly over the top. I've made several batches of the green bean fries, and here is the last one. It's a large batch, and sometimes they want to cling together when you have a lot of them, but these are turning out pretty well. And the frying actually gets easier as you get into the process. The first bunch weren't quite as good as the ones that have come out after that. But I have turned the oil off, turned the heat off so that we don't have any problem with the oil. And the last ones are out of here. Here we have our finished green bean fries, and they're nice and hot, so I'm going to put them on a serving platter. It made a lot. That was 1.5 pounds to start with, but it seems to grow when you add a coating to it and deep fry it. We're serving these with wasabi and green onion dip, and that was our previous video, so if you need to go back and look at that, if you want to use that, it's fine. You may serve them with ketchup or whatever dipping sauce you might like. I'm going to bring some over to my plate, and these are probably going to be best served with tongs. I have a small amount of the wasabi and green onion dip, so let's just take one of these and I'm going to dip it. And I tasted the wasabi and green onion dip for you, so I don't really need to do that, but I kind of need to taste the green bean fry for you without that dip. Tastes wonderful. I love green beans, and I love them cooked in a southern way. So I traditionally don't eat them undercooked, which would be perfectly cooked for most of you. But it doesn't have any crunch to it. It's nice and soft, definitely cooked. It has a really good flavor to it, and I think that's because of this coating that has been cooked on it. Now I'm going to take a part of the green bean fry that has the wasabi and green onion dip. It makes it so much better, so much more lively. The flavor is just bursting in my mouth, and occasionally you get a little bite of that salt because it's put on as coarse salt, and you just get it occasionally instead of having it mixed all the way through. It's really a good snack. I'm not declaring these as a healthy dish, but maybe healthier than some, and I hope you enjoy it for Super Bowl Sunday and at other sports events, or just while you're watching a movie or just being at home.